adults do stupid things sometimes, you know, because they're kids. And that's kind of the way they're wired. And then when they get to like middle high school, they push the limits even more because they want it. That's their job. That was described to me many years ago. That's their job, is to figure out where the limits are. You know, I remember when I was in the eighth grade, you know, and I was a pretty nice kid, but I grew up in the country. And we had this kid in our class who had a really, really bad hygiene. I'll never forget it as long as I live. I was mean. I was a mean, mean kid at that moment. Because all the kids were like, I don't want to sit next to him. I don't want to sit. And I says, well, why doesn't someone just tell him to take a bath? Okay, think about this. This is coming from an adolescent, a kid, you know. And I ended up supplying him with goods in his desk when no one was looking to take a bath with, which was just the meanest thing you could possibly do. I got in so much trouble. My parents had to come in and talk to me. I was dubbed the meanest kid around. I was like, how could you do that? Did you know about empathy? Did you think about how that kid would feel? I didn't think about how that kid would feel. I quite literally said, I'll solve the problem for you all so you'll stop complaining, right? So when I think about that, I obviously didn't have a lot of empathy feelings for this kid because he wasn't my friend, so therefore, why should I care? I'm going to solve the problem for everybody else, and I'll be the hero. That's my kid mind. It was a really stupid move and a terrible move and a hurtful move, and I got into a lot of trouble for it, but I was a kid. What I want, the purpose for this is I want you all to start thinking about the kids you deal with and really kind of remember, you know, what it was like to be a kid and not think cause and effect and not care about the limits and to even look to see if anybody was watching before you threw a rock or took something you weren't supposed to or cut in line. Because a lot of people did that before you cheated on a test, or if you did cheat on a test, before you lied to somebody. You know, you didn't think ahead about what that might be or what the repercussions might be. So that's the stuff I want you kind of to bring you to, because those are the kids you're working with when you're getting them in and out of the CAF, when you're getting them down the hall, when you're getting them on and off the bus, when you're working in small groups, is they do things for three primary reasons. My primary purpose when I did that, I can look back on that and reflect and say, it was clearly attention. It was clearly attention. I wanted the attention from my peers by doing something that would solve the problem that they were complaining about. But I didn't really care at the moment who I hurt to get that attention, which is pretty awful. But I don't consider myself a really awful person or a bad kid or anything like that. At that moment, that was the function of my behavior. And our three primary functions are going to always revolve around attention, avoidance, and control. You know, and so if you think about that, every human who walks the planet really seeks attention, avoidance, and control. Kids don't know how to do it the way they should without hurting feelings, some do, so don't generalize, without hurting feelings, without breaking rules, unless they've kind of experienced it first, gone through the process, or been taught it, you know, piece by piece by the adults, or coached. And then they start to grow and they mature and they go, oh, all those things, those coaching, those adults did for me. For some kids, it kicks in at 15. For some kids, it kicks in at 5. Depends on their family structure. For many kids, it doesn't kick in until they're 30. It really depends on their background. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, make sure to like and subscribe so you never miss another video. I speak and consult on school behavior, and I love to help districts solve some of these problems. See you next time.